Hello, and welcome to Mapping Entities to Tables. In this video, we will learn how entities are mapped to relational database tables. At the end of this video, you will be able to explain how an ER diagram translates into a relational database table with rows and columns. Entity relationship diagrams are the basic foundations for designing a database. In the relational database design, begin with an ER diagram, or ERD. And later map the ERD to the tables in a database. In this example, we use the ERD for entity book. Entity book has several attributes. The entity and its attributes will be mapped to a table. For ease of understanding, let's separate the entity from the attributes. In this case, entity book becomes a table with the same name book. All the attributes translate into columns in the table. We will now see how a table would be represented in a relational database model. A table is a combination of rows and columns. While mapping, the entity becomes the table. Having said that, the table has not yet taken the form of rows and columns. The attributes get translated into columns in a table providing the actual table form of rows and columns. Later we add some data values to each of the columns, which completes the table form. For the author example, the entity author becomes the table, and the attributes get translated to columns in the table. Adding some data values into the columns complete the table. You can now explain how an ER diagram translates into a relational database table with rows and columns. Thanks for watching this video.